Welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're going to take a look at the latest updates for Microsoft Teams, which make it a hub for teamwork in Office 365. We're going to look at the unification of Skype for Business into Teams, which means that Teams users get telephony and also combined presence and further Outlook integration. And also, Skype users get persistent chat, the new Teams experience, and integration with all the different apps and services that we have with hundreds of different apps. For extensibility. For IT, we're also going to show the unified control set across Teams and Skype for Business. And to do all this, I'm joined by Dan Stevenson from the Teams team. Welcome.
Hey, thanks, Jeremy. Good to see you.
Give Dan a warm round of applause.
You know, it's been really exciting the last few months since we launched, seeing people using Teams at the airport, at a show, obviously at work. But it's great to see how the product has really taken off so far.
Right, and it's been a huge, huge week for Microsoft Teams here as we're bringing together the communication and collaboration stack into one service. How did this all come about?
Yeah, so look, people have been using Teams for collaboration for a while. It's very natural to want to share with a team, have a chat, share a document, et cetera. Actually, 125,000 different companies are already using Teams in some form just in the last 6 months that we've been on. At the same time, they're using Skype for Business for their communications needs, telephony and meetings and calling. And those are very similar scenarios, so it kind of makes sense that you would want to have them together. It's kind of weird to want to keep switching contexts or compartmentalize your brain around doing a chat versus making a call versus going to a meeting. So we really want to interweave these into a seamless experience for our users. So that really led to saying, hey, what can we do here? Let's take the Skype for Business telephony, audio conferencing, cloud voice capabilities, bring those into Teams, really under the aegis of this hub for teamwork that is Microsoft Teams, so that you have one application where you can do all of your communications and collaboration capabilities.
Right, so, and we've also seen in terms of all the different updates that we made even this week around Teams, like being able to edit against files and do more collaboration control. So why don't we take a look at kind of what the team experience is and really show this unified set of experiences now that we've got in the one unified experience.
Yeah, absolutely. So let me just kind of orient ourselves in Teams a little bit. Here I am in one of my teams, and you can see I've got a chat going on with some of my colleagues here. We're actually in a team called Product Development, and then we're in a channel called Social Media. A channel is kind of a topical grouping within a team. It makes it easy to keep track of a couple different things going on at the same time. You know, it's kind of an interesting looking chat, though. It has, of course, text in it, but it's got a meeting recording, which is kind of interesting.
So media support, yeah.
Yeah, and that's new. It's got files. It's got, you know, here we have an email that came in. So you can email into a channel. You got somebody communicating over email. You want to bring that into the team. There was an attachment on that email. Naturally, that gets added. We've got, we've got more threaded conversations going on here. So I can pop this open. You can see a chat going back for a while. We've got a bot and an app in here. It's actually really powerful to see all these things coming together. And then, you know, if I look elsewhere across the app, of course, it's not just chat and what's in the chat stream. We have things like Microsoft Planner integrated that's providing task management in the context of the team, and we actually have a whole rich set of different types of applications.
And it's a direct hook of planners. This is all interactable. Any time that you're making any changes there, it's going to reflect, even if you go to the planner experience directly.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I should also mention we now have guests in the team, and you actually see that. I think one of the users posting here is labeled a guest. This is through the Azure AD B2B collab capability, where we can have authenticated, secure guests brought into a team. From Azure AD and fairly soon through MSA as well.
Very cool. And we see just a little bit of what looks like to be a teddy bear. So we've got Jiffies and, oh, sorry,
a
monkey.
Yeah, it's a monkey. Yes.
A monkey. Sorry about that. Sorry about that, monkey. So we've got a couple of other things that we can do in terms of dynamic chat and kind of the tools and things that people would like to use in terms of their personal lives as well and bringing that into the Teams environment so I can then communicate with things like with these or different memes, et cetera, in that chat experience. The great thing is, though, from an IT perspective, since we're all in IT, all these files that you're seeing here, the Excel, the PowerPoint file, those are being stored in SharePoint or OneDrive for Business. It's not using a local file system. That means a couple of things. A, the people that you're chatting with can access those files and work with you, co-author, those types of things. Make sure they can get to the files, whether they're on a mobile device or on the client here on a PC or on a Mac. But also, you get all the security and compliance controls that it gives you in terms of having the SharePoint and OneDrive for Business underpinnings as well.
Yeah, you know, I like to think that Teams is actually the best front end for SharePoint and OneDrive. There's no classic attachments in Teams. Everything you share is through the cloud. One of the things we just added, you know, of course you can take a file and pin it to a tab or open it up in Teams, whether or not it's in a tab. One of the things we just added is this edit button here, which actually will edit inside Teams. So it's running the Office Online web applications inside Teams.
Right.
I used to think it's kind of an 80-20 for the time you spend in Teams versus out. Maybe it's now 86-87% mm-hmm. of what you're doing with documents. You can actually stay in Teams.
Right, so a lot of richness, and again, this is something where you can camp in Teams all day pretty much, because all of the different tools that you're going to use, or the majority of them at least in terms of chat and working on files, is all there. So,
Speaking of chat, actually, so we also have private chat. I think I neglected to cover that. One of the cool features, oh, look, my kids are riding sheep again. I think we talked about that about a year ago.
Yes.
It's a recurring theme. One of the neat things that actually, this is the first time we're demoing this live and actually disclosing this. When I add somebody to a chat now, so go ahead and add Albert here. Actually, let me pick a group chat. Sorry, that didn't quite work. Let me add you to this group chat we have going on here. You notice when I'm adding Jeremy, when I typed his name in here, it's asking if I want to share the chat history with you.
Okay.
This is really powerful. So I've got a group chat going on with some folks, and I want to add somebody else into it. Heretofore, I had to copy and paste or kind of repeat myself. Now I can share, but I don't even have to share the whole history. I can choose, you know, maybe just the last day or two is actually what I want to bring you up to speed on.
Yeah, and a lot of the recent news that we've had with Teams, I think a lot of people are curious here. We've brought in more audio and video support, the voice and video support that we had traditionally inside of Skype for Business, now coming to Teams. So can you explain that a bit?
Yeah. So this is the big announcement, of course, in the news recently, where we took Skype for Business online capabilities and are lighting those up in Teams. Specifically, the ability to have Teams become your phone, just like Skype for Business is, and the ability for Teams online meetings to have dial-in conferencing. And what I've actually got here is in the app, I've got a dial pad up, which is very similar to what you would expect in any kind of a software phone, where I'm using Teams as my phone. Let's make a quick call though. Do you remember the switchboard number for Microsoft? Let's see if we can. I think
722-8080.
It's 88. Yeah, 882-8080. There we go.
Oh, either way. Okay.
Yeah. All right. So let's give them a call.
Hopefully this is the right number.
It is, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, or else someone's going to wake up kind of early.
Thank you for calling Microsoft. To reach us.
All right, so look, we got a robot. I think everybody's at a conference or something.
I think everybody's in Orlando this week, so that's probably just going to be an answering system. So that's cool. So you can use Teams then as your phone effectively. This is one of the great things with Skype and Teams is that you don't need to have a desk phone because you can have PSTN integration right through the Teams app.
Yeah, and you know, this is not something we just invented new for Teams. This is based on actually 20 plus years of experience we have building on-prem voice, cloud voice solutions, and now lighting those up in Teams.
Right, and you can always move from Skype for Business into Teams, right? So if you've got Skype for Business running now, how does that experience look
into Teams? Yeah, absolutely, great question. So one of the key things to know is, of course, your phone number stays the same. Mm-hmm. In fact, your voicemails go with you too, for better or worse. So if you've been punting on a voicemail, you keep punting on it. One of the things that's, I think, a little bit of a nuance, but it's really important to understand, you can run these applications side by side. And admins have a whole set of controls and capabilities around how they want to manage the deployment of Teams alongside Skype for Business, and when and how they want to have their users move from Skype for Business to Teams. You can run them in a side-by-side mode. You can choose for one user or many users to have Teams become their primary receive client for incoming phone calls, and then you can also just move the whole company over when you're ready.
And you don't have to move then from Skype into Teams. You can do that at your own pace. So users then don't need to switch or do other things in order to make calls here. You kind of get that side-by-side capability. So kind of what people are comfortable with, they can keep using, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So the other thing is, of course, we've invested even more in interop. So if you're a Skype for Business user and I'm a Teams user, that's great. We can chat back and forth. You're not going to get the GIFs. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. But that's okay.
You get a little bit of emoticon stuff.
Yeah, you can at least do
parentheses, ASCII kind of emoticons.
That's good. And calling and video interrupt too. So I can make a video call to you. The idea is that you're not fearing that you're missing out on anything. You can comfortably move to Teams. We're ready as a user, as a group of users, as a company, and still have people you work with in Skype for Business.
Very cool. And we've also got things like the video calling that we can do in addition to just the telephony experiences, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So If I keep going then on the thread in terms of the integration here, Teams has really had meetings for kind of a long time in terms of what you could do with things that were natively scheduled inside of Teams. But you know, the Outlook integration has traditionally been kind of an Outlook and Skype for business thing. What's the news there? What's different there?
Yeah. So even before I hop over to Outlook, just check this out. The meetings I schedule in Teams now have a phone number and a passcode. So I can dial in, anybody else can dial in. It's actually on a newer meetings, audio, video, screen sharing technology stack than Skype for Business Online with even higher quality and improved reliability. But let's go to Outlook and I'll just show you here. I've got my calendar up, and then you notice I have a couple add-in buttons there. I'm in side-by-side mode.
Right.
So I have the exquisite pleasure of being able to schedule Teams and Skype meetings whenever I want. Here I've scheduled a Teams meeting, and just like you would expect, or I'm about to schedule, just like you would expect with Skype for Business, it populates the body of the calendar item with the coordinates, the URL, et cetera. I can send it off, people click and join, and we're good to go.
And even external users, if they just have the PSTN information like you can see here on the screen, they'll be able to join as well, right?
Yeah, and coming relatively soon, they'll be able to join even through the client if they don't have an account as well.
Very cool. So now that we've got all of that information in, what about things like Skype meeting broadcast? Are those experiences also going to come to Teams?
Yeah, the general roadmap is that we will, or the general plan, I should say, is that all of the capabilities in Skype for Business Online, we will light up over time underneath Teams. And we'll publish some more detailed roadmap information in the future. We also have some information online at aka.ms/Skype and Teams, where people can go and learn more about kind of how to plan their roadmap and their own migration.
So some of the great experiences that I like to use in terms of mobile is kind of like the easy meeting join, you know, whether I'm out and about, even sharing screens. Do we have some Teams experiences you can show on mobile?
Yeah, we sure do. All right, so I'll bring up my phone here. There I am. All right, so look, I've got I got my notifications here. Growbot sent me a card. This is a great way to triage what's going on. There's notifications in the desktop client as well. It's kind of where I spend the better part of my morning. But
right.
It's great to keep up with that on the go. Going to chat here. Hey, look, I can even show off the sheep riding if I wanted to. I won't bore you with that. But I've got all my chats. I can mark, you know, read the ones I need to keep up on. I've got my Teams. So if I'm on the team here, we were just in here. So I can see the chat that we were having in that meeting, the email that was forwarded. And this is new. When I click on the tabs now, I've got access to all the files. So any file that was shared in that channel, I now can see here in the Teams client. And because we have Office apps for the phone, I can actually open a PowerPoint from here, edit it, and save it back here without ever opening my laptop.
Very cool.
And share it within the team, which is really cool.
And it'll natively link you into the apps that are installed on your phone. So things like the Office clients or Power BI, for example, those types of experiences, we can go straight in through the Teams app and use those experiences kind of natively on the phone.
Yeah, absolutely. And look, I got meetings, of course, so I can one-click join or one-thumb join into my meeting straight into Teams. And new, I have calling. So now my phone is a phone.
Very
and Teams,
cool.
Which is great. And we, of course, have the native dial integration as well. So when I receive an incoming call, even if the screen's locked, I can still see an answer.
So let's switch gears here and talk about what this means for the IT admin. I think we're in a room full of IT admins, actually. What's the management experience like then in Microsoft Teams?
Yeah, so let me cut over to that here. So here I am in the O365 Admin Center.
Mm-hmm.
This is the Teams section of the Admin Center. A few things have changed here. We've actually added the ability to control different categories of users. So for example, if I have guest users in my tenant, I can give them a different set of permissions than regular users.
Mm-hmm.
I can also allow and deny applications, connectors, apps, sideloaded apps, across all the teams in my tenant from here.
Right.
One of the other things that we announced, though, is that we're building a new admin portal, bringing together Skype for Business and Microsoft Teams into a single administration experience with much finer grain controls than the ones you see here.
Very cool.
I just have a couple screens to show you that. We've been talking a little about that with a few folks this week. You can see here I'm managing my users. I have all their information. In fact, I can manage how I want to move them and when I want to move them from Skype to Teams. And then I've also got, of course, what you would expect in terms of managing where my conference bridges are, managing my phone number allocation. Everything that I'm doing, it's the same backend as Skype for Business. So everything I'm doing with Skype for Business, I now manage and set that both for Teams and Skype for Business in this new admin center.
Very cool. So we've seen then all the admin experiences. What about developers? Because we've got a lot of developers out here. Anybody a developer out here? all of you are IT pros and not developers, it sounds like. So, but if you are working with developers, we've got some stuff for them as well, right?
Yeah, we do. So the first thing is just to discover apps in Teams. Of course, you just go here to discover apps. There'll be a few more entry points coming soon on that.
Okay.
We have quite a few. You can see a really rich catalog here of what we've got available. We have a website, dev.office.com, where you can learn more about writing your own tabs, which are applications that live within a frame in Teams, or bots, which are conversational agents, that you, like Grobot that I was talking to earlier,
right?
Or connectors, which are service message pumps that can push information, and now you can actually interact with the connector. So if it sends a message into the team, you can click a button, approve a bug, change a date on a schedule item, back and forth between the application, all within the context of your chat.
Very cool. So, and we're doing things like supporting BotKit as a framework. So this is really a great tour in terms of all the things that we're doing in Teams, all the integration, the IT experiences, the dev experiences. Where should people go to learn more?
Yeah, so aka.ms/Skype and Teams is where you can learn more about this journey from Skype for Business to Teams and really bringing the Skype for Business telephony and conferencing capabilities into mm-hmm. Teams. And then, of course, you can start using Teams. It's there. It's in Office 365. Teams.microsoft.com/start will get you going.
It's really great seeing all the progress. Thanks for joining us today, Dan. And for everyone watching, stay tuned. We're going to have more capabilities coming to Teams as we progress that. We're going to cover that all on Microsoft Mechanics. That's all the time we have for this show. We'll see you next time.